myself Alok Ranjan representing Parker Hannifin India, and my colleague is also over there. He's a sales engineer for Daily Region. He's Anand Rai, and we are here to demonstrate something about a controller. Some of us knows, I think all of us knows pretty well nowadays, controllers, familiar with this word. So actually basically we'll talk on the term, generalized term of the controller. We'll not go on the Parker specific things. First we'll go generalized controller, what a controller is and how it is going to you know, work on the recent markets and all. First thing is I'll just, yeah, okay, I can put it. So basically we'll discuss about what controller we have right now. You can see over here also, we have a controller that is called the Parker Automation Controller Pack, and it's going to handle your various axes. It's a complete solution for a motion control. So initially we'll go with the term by term. First one, we'll go with a perspective of industry, how it is going to be used in an industry. So first one we have is a product integration. In product integration, what we say is previously we had a controller where only we used to handle signals, digital input outputs. We have a digital input output, we'll modulate the things, we'll give a command and a drive will start. It will give a motion on that signals. But nowadays what we are doing is we are giving a complete solution so that a person should not go to different manufacturers. They should not look for a drive, a controller. So everything is inbuilt here, all the controllers will be inbuilt here, all the motions we call multi-axis motion. So it can handle up to 32 axis with a controller. You can handle 32 axis, you can make a various profile out of that. Next one will be your signal handling. If you don't have a 32 axis, because in the general industry will be handling 3 axis, 2 axis, or maybe we want to use just simple as a PLC, not even as an access controller. So it can give you the advantage of using this only as a PLC. You can cut down all the programming part of other motion controls and it will act just a simple PLC also. Next will come other features. What I am going to tell is web visualization is another feature what we are giving in this controller. So you can sit in an office, a management can sit in an office and just track down all the product lists, what it is going to be produced in the soft floor. So no need to, for a manager, it's not required, right, to install a software. Just he want to see, he want to control the things by seeing the statistics. So that statistics he can see on the web visualization on the normal browser, web browser, say Internet Explorer. Those features I'll demonstrate you maybe in the next slides. Next we are going with for engineer's perspective. What we are giving this controller, how it is going to be easy for an engineer to handle this. Right, for an engineer what we want is it should be, we should be equipped with lots of enhanced tools so that we can program the access in a better way. So for that we have various programming language we are supporting in this. So we are supporting almost 6 language, where 4 graphical language we are supporting. That will be function block diagrams, your continuous flow charts, your ladder logics. And our structure text also we support. For the textual language we support structure text and instruction list. So generally whatever language we are using in industry, we are supporting it right now in this PLC. Again, for the management perspective, if you'll discuss, say for example we have a complete line where we are producing something which is going to be winded, which is going to be unwinded, and which is going to control the tension of your line from the industry perspective. So no need to program everything in the different programs. You can have a line segment specific programming you can do in this only. One project is sufficient to program the full automation of the industry. That also I'll show you how to segregate the lines and how to make the segments. Maybe that will be more on the industry point of view I'm talking about. Just will come on the, so okay, I will just demonstrate the our controller here, and you should be familiar with all the hardware what we have in this controller, so that in next if I am programming it or I am using it, we can use it in a proper way if you know the hardware. So okay, you can see over there, this is a 24 volt supply we need for this. we have all the status LEDs, whether what is the condition of your controller that moment, whether it is healthy or some error is there or some logic errors are there. This will be demonstrating over here on the LED part. The pattern of the LED, how it glows, the colors, it will tell you what is the condition exactly that moment. We'll discuss for this also later. We are supporting two USB. So here that USB will be used for basically it will be used for your saving the projects, saving the backups, or maybe you have an online trending of an application where it is going when it is taking a high current, high load, that all the trendings you can just log in, you can save that data in your USB and you can use in a future for analysis purpose. So this is the port called EtherCAT. Maybe nowadays we have moved to next communication level, next generation, where it is faster, EtherCATs. It gives 100 Mbits per second speed as a communication speed for the drives. So we are supporting EtherCAT, and lots of devices in the market nowadays are available for EtherCAT. Thousands of devices are there which communicates on the protocol of EtherCAT.
Just a question.
Yes, sir.
The other thing I hear is about the Internet of Things, right? And this dichotomy, whether the Internet of Things will be controlled by IT or by automation.
Actually,
so how does EtherCAT fit into this, if you can explain?
EtherCAT will not go with IT, what I'm telling. The programming part, if the device I'm going to program it or assign it, it should be, it will be based on TCP/IP. IT comes in picture when we want to handle this device on a server. Say for example, I'm sitting in Chennai and I want to handle a device which is over here in Delhi. So in that case, we have to ask a permission from the IT department of that, so that he can give the permission to enter in that server domain, and then we can handle the, you know, the controllers. So that time we have to take the permission of the IT, and that much is required from the IT department for that, so that they can specifically specifies that this can communicate, this can enter in that server. It's a safe for the IT area.
So there's a dedicated Ethernet network,
yeah,
to handle all such devices.
Yeah, they have to dedicate.
And it has got no relationship with the LAN of the factory which is handling the other office.
No, exactly. For that only we want the IT help, so that they can specifically dedicate a ID number for a device if you want to put it on a server. Otherwise, it is just isolated. It's just from a specific computer to that device only. Apart from that, I don't think it's any other use of the IT department for this.
My question is still not answered. Mm-hmm. When it is isolated, let us say for all practical purposes, you have taken a decision, you don't need a connection on the main server. Mm-hmm. It's a factory automation system being implemented. Mm-hmm. Yet, when you talk of EtherCAT, there will be an Ethernet cabling.
Yeah, sure.
So this cabling, is this the responsibility of the automation department, and is it a cable which is completely separate from the other factory cable which has been laid for the office administration and all those kind of things?
No, actually that will be responsibility for the automation department. And that cable, EtherCAT cable, is same as the Ethernet cable. It's not different. So that existing cable can be used. But that responsibility will be for the automation department, not for the IT, for this one. Okay, we'll move next here. So this is just the hardware part I specified. We have 2 GB of SD card for storage of the programming language, what we are programming. That programming program should be stored on a SD card. Next we have, you can see over here, 2 Ethernet ports are there. If it's not visible clearly, I'll just show it here also. 2 Ethernet ports and separate IP address you can assign to each and every port. And this will be used for downloading the projects, uploading the projects, and configuring the device. these are the IO modules. In the market, we can't only rely on one communication protocol. If you want to fit in an industry, we have to support various communication protocols, and we are supporting almost all the, you know, important protocols what industry is going through nowadays. So we are supporting Profibus, ControlNet, DeviceNet, then Modbus RTU, Modbus TCP. So it covers approximately the market. You can fit with that machine where you have this communication protocols. Okay, this is the programming language what I discussed earlier. We are supporting two text language, that is structure text and instruction list. Apart from that, four graphical language, your continuous function chart, function block diagram, ladder diagram, and sequential function chart. And sometimes it is not sufficient that if you are programming in one specific language, you need to integrate some two languages so that you can make your program more flexible, you can handle more complex applications. So we are supporting that also. You can write in a structure text, add with a ladder, and you can incorporate it in the same program. This is just a small demonstration of all the program what we have written here. And I think better I can explain once I'll open the software and we'll go through how it works. For defining any of the motion control programs, first you need to know the state how you are going to move from one step to another step. That we are calling it state diagram. You can't directly jump from one state to another without knowing whether it is feasible or not. You have to decide with a customer sitting and according to the application. That again, this part I'll explain in the program side once I'll come to. I think this all the things we are going to cover in the program. Okay, just a brief look up on the CNC control also. This is the complete package. This can handle CNC up to 9 dimensions. It can control. We have readily made function blocks for gantry system also. That also I'm going to just give you a small simulation mode demonstration here for the gantry systems. And you can see we can support XYZ gantry, XYZ theta, XYG theta and W for tool offsets also we are supporting in this. Readily function blocks are available for a basic gantry system. If you want to customize the block, that is also possible. You can customize your block, you can make changes in the block. Again, you can put it in the library for your future use also. Again, we are supporting the robotics also in the same controller. And recently we have launched 3 versions of this, maybe because in all the PLC you are not going to use robotics or CNC. So we have a 3 version where one only PLC can be controlled, a kind of a PLC it will act. The other it will act as a PLC and a motion control. And the third it will give you the full option of controlling the CNC, the PLC part and the soft motion parts also. These things are just viewed of the program. Just anyway, I'm going to show you the program demonstration also. Okay, if you are customizing a program for a research basis, or we are making a program for a specific application, then we want to save it so that it can't be copied or it can't be misused. So we can license it, we can put a password on that, and we can, you know, save it. It's features are available for giving a password and blocking the things. Communication, I told you we are supporting approximately all the communication which are present in the recent market. We are supporting Profinet, Profibus, Ethernet, Modbus TCP, OPC server and dual LAN capabilities. This is our HMI, we are not going to discuss about that. And it has an inbuilt capability of visualization also. So now no need of taking a separate HMI, it can act as a SCADA also. You can, I'll just show you that on the program part again. And this is how it looks in a complete solution from Parker side. You can see it's any other devices, field devices, it will be communicating on a EtherCAT for all the EtherCAT devices, even the third party devices we can take it on the EtherCAT. Modbus TCP we can support, any Siemens machine we can talk to directly. The next version will be giving the Profinet inbuilt slave port also. In this it is not there, we are going to release it soon. And the next for AB machines also we can talk directly, we have Ethernet IP. So we are trying to cover the market here. So I'm just going to, I think, slide part I'm not going to take that much. Now we are going to demonstrate the live demo of the how it works, the motion control, the one axis I have here, and the two axis I'm going to show in the simulation mode, the runtime mode. Okay, I'm going to open a new project here and we'll go step by step, and if any clarification, if you have worked on the other PLCs, any feedbacks, any suggestion, it will be most welcome for us, because anyway new product, so we'll be looking for that. I'm just going to open a new project. See, we have a three option when I click on the new project, that is a empty project. If you have any other controller other than Parker also, you can just make some projects, because it's a common platform IC standard programming we are supporting, that is CODESYS 61131. So it is like it is readily understood by the other programmers, because in the field people are using CODESYS nowadays, it's a standard program.
Device also.
Other device in the sensor?
Any other PLC apart from Parker?
See, apart from Parker, you can't control it right now, but the platform is CODESYS. If you have programmed on the other controller, you can import the program and you can use it here. Or you can take our program, export it, and you can use on the other, because that is what I mean to say, it's a common programming language, CODESYS, IC standard language. So you can export the program from here, you can import in other of the controllers also, it's not a problem. So I'm going to open the standard project that is meant for Parker. So I'll just open it. Actually, I have made already one project for the name. So you can see over here, you can see we have the various options what we are going to put. You told any other controller also, you can make a program, but right now it is you can make a program and export, you have to export the things for using to the other controller. I am just going to select our controller. You can see the part number of the controller and you can select it over on the library. The part number will be mentioned on the top, it is mentioned. We have a controller pack 320. C. Here C represents, it will control your CNC axis, it's a complete solution if it is a C. If it is a M, it will only act as a PLC and a motion control. So we have a complete solution over here for demonstration in IIT. So we have a complete CNC package also in this. I've opened a new project. Okay, after putting a project, we need to add the axis, how many axis we are going to control with that project. So right now we have one drive, that is we are going to call it as an axis, and we can say it as a x axis, and we are going to configure it for the x axis. So this device is going to communicate on EtherCAT, so I am going to just add an axis under the EtherCAT master. This is your device tree. You can see it's a total device tree. Here I can add a EtherCAT master. Any other device which is communicating on the EtherCAT, I'm going to add over the EtherCAT master. So I'll just have to right click And I want to just show you one more feature. Actually, if you don't know exactly how many devices and which devices connected, because it's a going to be a complete line. If you have a 32 devices connected, you can't have the look on the all the 32 device. What a feature available is, you can scan for the device. It will tell you how many devices connected, and you can directly copy it on your project. So no need to manually go and add. But if you want to add manually, there is a procedure of adding the manually. You can go and add for the device. But right now I'm just gonna show you that how it scans. This for the scan for the device. No gateway selected. Just okay. This is not the online what I'm showing here. It is just showing that it has been established the communication from the PC to the PLC. I will say okay. Now I can scan for my device. So it will scan and tell me how many devices are connected on the EtherCAT. Right now it is showing that one device has been connected with EtherCAT and readily available, because we have it in the our library. We can customize the library also. It's not a big issue in that. And right now the Compex is connected. It is showing that Compex 3 EtherCAT is connected to the controller right now. So I'm just gonna see any difference. What the project I have made is, I have not taken this manually. So if not, I have not taken it manually, it is going to show the difference that in your project side you don't have the device. So it's very easy to take it. I'll just say copy all. So whatever the hardware it is detecting, I'm taking on the program side, and I'm going to say okay. So you can see the controller has been appeared here. Our device has been appeared here. For this to control, you need a generic, what you call a soft motion slave.
Before selecting scanning for device, you mm-hmm. selected some gateway. How do we select which gateway is to be added?
Yeah, actually if we are connecting with we have some other softwares installed in this mm-hmm. for the HMI and all, so everything will be having on a specific gateway. For this device, actually I just note it down, I'm not clear on that. Because it is showing we have some 2-3 Parker softwares in that, so it will be having a other gateway for the other device. So that's it's giving me the option, and we'll just select one gateway which is appropriate. I'm selecting it right now. But I'll right now I can't say it's a hidden trial, but I'll just note down this question and just say why how specifically we can select the gateway, because it's a it's a IT part where we will discuss with the IT department, and they will say us this gateway is suitable for this device, and then we'll select that. So our IT department will select this this port, and this gateway will be suitable for your device, and you can go with this. So this specifically how we select the gateway, I'll just come back to you on that,
because that's an important part of communication.
Sure. So we have added one device in this communication on the controller, and because it's a common platform CODASYS language soft motion, so we have to add a axis where it can execute the commands. We have taken a device, we have to add an axis on that. I'm just going to insert one axis. We'll say okay. So you can see one axis is there, and because any move command or any command what you are going to give for a machine, you have to specify the name, a specific name of that axis, maybe x, y, g, theta or tool offset, what you are going to specify. So I'm just going to name it as a x. I'll give a caps, it will be better. So I've made one axis. Whatever axis we have made, whatever device is connected, it has to call that device either cyclically. What is your scan rate of the device which is connected to the controller? We should know all the things, and we are going to specify in the task manager. We are going to call that thing. We are going to. So it's not a cyclic event. It's a real-time communication. It has to be a real-time communication to give all the commands and datas. I'm going to give a external, because it's an external device connected on that. And our device supports 2000 microsecond as a scan rate for the with a PLC. So it can synchronize with 2000 microseconds. So that specific part is not coming actually that side. Okay, now here. That part we have to specify here with what scan rate it will going to synchronize with the controller. So it will be given by the manufacturers. If you have a third party device, they will be telling you what will be suitable scan rate for this. I'm just going to feed as 2000 because this will support 2000 scan rate as a microsecond. This unit is in microsecond.
So automatically it is in microseconds, or do we have to specify?
It's automatically in the microseconds.
In case it will be in milliseconds accordingly.
You have to give the according value. Yeah, it's a example is for the external events here. This, when you select this external event ECM DC, that unit it has been specified here. It's not the unit of, yeah, it's a microsecond. Actually, in the next where we are going to specify in the master. Right now I'm just calling it for my drive. When I'll come to the master, that coupler, the EtherCAT coupler, there also we have to specify the same thing, that it has been given that it will communicate on 2000 microseconds. So that here you will see the units. I'll just show you the next slide. Okay, here you can see this cycle time is a microsecond. So this is the same thing, I have to specify what I have given for the drive here, that will be 2000. Then we'll go to our device, and device also we have to make some settings so that it will be readily available for communicating, transferring all the data without any errors. So I'll just enable that sync time, that is 2000 microsecond, and now our drive is ready for taking the command from the controller. We have three options how it is going to execute the motions. Finite is the linear motion, linear position what we are going to give, say 2000 mm, 3000 mm, 5000 mm. If you are giving a modulo, it will be going to repeat after that position, again it will make to a zero. That is basically it is used for a circular motion, and that will be used, we are going to use for a linear motion. So I think configuration part. Yeah, it's a degree, you can say it's a 360 degree, you can specify whatever degree you want. And it will, it's a rotation, it will not continuously give you the position after whatever you have specified, say for example 300. Again that motion will make to a zero, and again from zero it will start with 300. So it's a circular motion. That will specify in the program side whether you want to be in a relative way or the absolute way. Okay, so I'll just show you one small demonstration on this. Yeah, actually I just, before that I wanted to show some of the features of this. See, if you go on the practical application on an industry point of view, what we want is we have a several, you know, machines, big lineups, we want to make it in a segments. For example, what I told you, we will be having a winder section, we'll be having a unwinder section, in between we'll be having tension controllers. So for each and everything, you can't make a separate project. It will be very cumbersome for you, for a programmer, for a person who is controlling the industry. So here we have a feature, we can add multiple application in between one. Say for example, I can add one more application, and I can say, or a better easy way to do is just you can copy and paste also, that will be fine. You can copy and paste it. So you can say we have one more application, I can just rename it according to my section, I can put that particular section's program in this, and we can execute whenever we want. There is a feature available, it will execute only that application that moment of time. So you right click and you can set active application. So once you make it a set active application, it will load that application on that particular point of time. So a person can just have a multiple applications here, he can go to the several sections and he can download that one. Particularly he can activate and make it online, and he can download the things. So multiple applications are possible. Even you can have a multiple hardware configuration and you can select which configuration you want to download. Multiple hardware configuration is also possible. We can add a multiple device. Okay, my right click is slow. Okay. So again, we can add our multiple hardwares here. Basically, multiple hardwares we are not going to use. We are going to use a simulator, so that if you are traveling, you can program your simulations, you can program your moves, and again, when you have a hardware, you can just directly download on that and you can use it. So you can utilize your time. If you don't have a device also, the basic motto is you can program without the device. You can simulate it, you can run it, and it will be exactly behaving the same way what the original drive and the access will behave. So I'll just open the project for the demonstration what I have made it. Which case, ma'am?
The present,
it will be rotary because it will be continuously moving. So it's we can't. Yeah, you can simulate it for the linear also and for the rotary also. Yes. Yeah, we are online here. You can see I have one device. Actual device, this is the global pack which I have taken here, and I have taken one more hardware configuration. What I want to show here is I can take a multiple hardware configuration in the same device. I have taken a simulator also at the same time here, so I can simulate while traveling. I can make a program, I can show it to our customers, we can keep it for the research work also. We can simulate because we can't have a 32 axis when we are making a 32 axis program. So we can sit in office, we can simulate the 32 axis over here. I can just show you how to add the extra axis. The place where I add one axis, you can just again right click and add further axis. You can keep on adding the axis till 32. So maximum axis it can control is the 32, including the master. Okay, now I'll just show you the visualization part. Okay, just a very raw program I have made. Whatever the block we are taking, the motion blocks, in the soft motion we have various motion blocks to just tell a command that you want to move absolute or you want to move a relative or you want to home the position after a specific motion. So everything, the templates are readily available with us, so no need to take a separate HMI and make a design. Here one advantage what you got is a person who is programming the thing, if he has moved from your firm, from your company or from your department, it's a standard thing. So it's easy to understand the next person which is coming on the job. So I'm just going to give a command which will just move it continuous. It's a continuous move, it's not absolute. I'm not going to specify any position for this, that you have to move 500 mm or you have to move 360 degree. It will be continuously moving till I give the stop command for this. Next, we will show you the absolute moves also. Just I'm going to give, for that I have to specify with what velocity my axis has to move. So I'm just going to specify the velocity here. Maybe I'll give 3. That will be 3 units per second. You can say 3 revolutions per second. Acceleration, how fast it should reach that velocity, I'm going to specify here. Maybe 10. Deacceleration, it will be 10 will be fine. Jerk, 100. All these parameters are application based. According to application, you are going to feed the data. And the direction in which you want to move your axis. So I'll say maybe positive axis. And these things I'm gonna force it here. That is, again, I want to tell you the good feature of this one. It's a wash table. It's a diagnostic tool which we are giving. You can just force and check the values. Once you are satisfied that these things are working fine, you can take it on the visualization or on the HMI or on the SCADA, and you can finalize the things for that. So for forcing, I'm just giving it a control F7. I'm gonna say we'll see whether it runs. Okay, I think my motion is running. My one axis is running right now. You can see it over here. There is a motor connected on the back side, and this is the shafts. I can control the speed. I can control the direction. I can control the position with this one. So it's a continuous movement. One thing I discussed when we were going through the presentation is, when you are designing a motion, when you are designing a specific application, you should know the state diagram. From this, where the next step it has to go. If you are just giving a next command without completing a command, it can go to an access error. It can be health hazard also. The machine, it is hazardous for the operators. So I'm just again gonna stop it. So control F7. We have to give a stop command. I've just make us these things, just I've made it for force. You can just make it on the visualization or on the SCADA, the buttons, or it will be from your field, the inputs which are coming from the field to stop the axis. So those inputs you can integrate in this various digital inputs and outputs, even the analog inputs and analog outputs. It will support 1000 input, and it can more than 1000 also, but I'm telling you the scan rate of 1000 inputs will be around 1000 microseconds. It can update 1000 inputs on a 1000 microsecond speed, this controller. And 20 IO modules you can add in this controller, as far as you are maintaining the 3 ampere current rating from the controller to the IO modules. After 20, if you want to add extra modules, if your application needs more than that, maybe 2000, 5000 or 10000 modules, 10000 input outputs, we are giving a power station after each and every 20 segment, which will boost up the ampere ratings, and again you can keep on adding the modules, IO modules on that controller. I'm just gonna
have any API also along with this, so that we can access these variables from any, let's say, LabVIEW, MATLAB or
exactly, it is compatible with LabVIEW. You can control with a LabVIEW.
For that you have a DLL API or something?
That we'll be providing you soon. It's not has been released to us also, so we'll be giving you, we'll be having from the division giving to. But I think you can communicate on LabVIEW on TCP/IP also. You can give the command directly.
TCP/IP is fine.
Once it comes to TCP/IP, you can connect to anything. But from the same platform, let's say LabVIEW, there should be some API or something from where we can access these variables, so that it directly communicates there.
Till now, I think I'll suggest better we can go with the TCP/IP. You can access all the variables from there. This will act as a slave for you. And LabVIEW will be master for you. You can give the command from there.
And then some real-time issues may come.
That real-time issues, I don't think the scan rate is pretty fast for that.
Fast, really?
So, have you faced any problems?
Yes, sir. With some other system, let's say backup, they give TwinCat, no? They have TwinCat running in the back interface.
Okay.
They claim that it runs on real-time, and it does so quite okay. For this, what do you say?
This will be also pretty good if you can try it in your lab and you can give us the feedback.
Okay.
And we have one tab also here for a customer feedback. So anytime any feedback will be very helpful for us.
So programming space, workspace and this both are same. Configuring and programming in the same platform you are doing.
Everything is same here only, same platform. I can program it here, I can add the access. And I can show you one more feature.
This entire thing is free of charge. You can.
Yeah, exactly. It comes with the device. If you have bought a controller, it comes with the controller. So no extra charges for the software.
Every time you take a new software, you have to add on some plenty of previous things.
No, now it is all in one Unity. It is downloadable. Patches. You have plenty of patches.
Once yeah, exactly. Now it will be under one software.
In your older version, there was plenty of patches were there.
Now it comes under one software. You can see even the visualization is there. Even your programmings are there. So we have tried to incorporate lot of things under one software, so it should not be confusing. Mm-hmm. Should not be too many softwares to handle. I'll just open it.
So, what exactly you learned from this presentation?
I'll just
immediate quiz.
No, actually, still small simulation I have to still show. Just I'll show you for the two gantry system also if they want to see. I'll just show
you.
No. Just I'm just looking for a my program where I can stop the access. Okay, we got it here. ZMC stop.
So I will be giving CDs only to those who answer my quiz after. I have bunch ready for you.
But you announced yesterday last week. Yesterday.
Surprise.
Yeah.
Just stop the access.
We are not mentally prepared for the quiz.
Applications, we're gonna run it. So again, because I had a multiple device, I told you I can enable that particular application in that instant of time. In the same program, I had 2-3 applications. This is one of the simulation application. Just I'm going to start it right now. Just we have to right click and set active application as, and it will enable that particular application on that moment of time. And now I can go online with this application, and you can see when I'm starting the thing on the simulation mode, here a small rectangle box with a message displayed that it's in the simulation mode. So now when you click online, it will not be connected with your controller, it will just be simulating the things. And for reaching here, for enabling the simulation, you have to click online and you have to enable the simulation, that is ticked over here. If you'll untick it, and then you can try with the controllers also. I'm just going online on that. We'll see what message it comes. Just this demonstration is just to show the how enhanced the visualization part is. Because really, if you are installing any application, it should be operator friendly. It should be user friendly. I'm going to run this access. You can install this thing on any of the laptop, any of the PC. This is just a PLC controller. It's a PLC control with a complete motion control. That is, I'm telling a robotics control.
How many axes
That I told you, sir. It can control on an EtherCAT up to 32 axes complete. So, including master, it will be controlling 32 axes with your EtherCAT.
How will be building the web pages on this?
Just that also I just demonstrated. Any of the internet, any browser or Internet Explorer, just you have to open that one and type the IP address of the specific device.
That is fine. How I will
that is to
fine. But how I will be creating those pages inside this? So this will be acting as a web server when I access through a browser.
Mm-hmm.
But how I will create those pages inside this?
See, you can't create all the pages on the web browser. Just specific control pages will be given to you on the web browser, mm-hmm. and that is readily programmed. So it's not editable what you can do. Just you can give a control what you want to control from the web browser. Out of that, what we have given to you, a specific parameters we have given that you can control from the web browser. Out of that, you can enable those some of the parameters, you can disable also some of the parameters. Maybe you can configure your IP address from the web browser. You can configure your password protective devices from your web browser. That I'll just show you how many things you can do it on the web browser. Just run the simulation here. I'll just go on the main control. Okay, I think because of some small earthing issue, it's not clicking on that one. These things, the earthing should be pretty, strong. Otherwise, any small dummy voltage or anything, it will hang your PCs and your mouse will not work. So, that's what I'm facing it right now. Actually, let me check any other template is opening.
See, your program should not work in one go. But I mentioned, see, unless you are not capable of debugging the program, it's only 20% learning. So what he is just trying to show you how to debug the issue. This is the real challenge for an automation engineer in the field.
Every time it happens.
You get everything ready. Whenever you go in a field for installation, then you.
New problem will come. New problem.
That is what. And then your debugging skill, experience, everything will come into picture.
This? Networking.
Actually, this charger was creating the problem. I removed this charger and now it is working.
Oh, good.
This is?
This is a
web page actually, just showing that. I think that's
exactly. It's not a web page, sir. It's a visualization page. What I told you, doesn't need a HMI anymore now with this software.
Visualization you are creating on a web server. That is what I understand.
No, it's I'm creating in the software itself.
But how you will be serving?
This page I'm not going to serve on the web. Only on the web. What I told that time also, we have a specific, parameters which you can visualize from the web. Not everything from the web.
But how I will access this page?
It's kind of a SCADA for you.
Fine. So
it has to be installed in the PC and
yes. SCADA. If I want to have this screen on my laptop, how I will be getting that?
I'll just show it. It's like you are telling the development and you are getting on the online also.
Yeah. See, because once you said that the visualization is a. Part of this controller, so I need not to go for another HMI or something.
Exactly.
So then I should be able to access this. And what I understand, I can access through an IP address. Is it true?
Not exactly. It's inbuilt, and you can now access with the software. It comes with the software. Just once you install the software, just like you are making a HMI page for a specific HMI, just you have to make in.
So for visualization also, I have to install a software on a.
The same software PC. Is sufficient.
No other. See, ultimately, see, software is sufficient for development. If I am going to give this kind of a solution to a customer, I am not going to give this software to him.
We have not segregated this. If you are giving, we are giving a complete solution. The development, you are talking as a development and the runtime. Some of the customers, you are giving the runtime, not the development part. Till now, we have not segregated the things. We are giving the full package. They are going to program and they are going to use it also.
No, but what I understand from web visualization, basically, we will be able to access pages through a web server. And web server is residing inside this controller.
What we are doing here with the web server is you can change the IP address, you can give the passwords.
I'm not able to access the tags and other things.
Tags? No. From the web, you can't access the tags actually. So that is what a specific parameters has been given that you can access from the web. That full list we can give it to you, how many things you can access with the web and what you can't do with the web. And on that parameters, you can select which you want to enable and which you don't want to enable. Web visualization, that is what I told you, you can you can see your device on the web, you can see whether it is communicating, you can configure the IP address with the web without the software.
Admin access.
You can see the list, how much the production has been happening there, some of the crucial parameters which will be displaying over there. And our target was like on the PC of the manager's PC or on the person who is controlling the things, he should not be having the software. He can just go on the browser and he can put the IP address and you can see the crucial parameters on that.
Okay, but who will be defining those crucial parameters? I will be doing...
We have a full list and you can select out of that. We have a list that you can access.
Are these parameters basically a parameter of a controller or it's a parameter of my process?
It's a parameter
controller.
Of the controller and
controller.
Some
controller.
Of the process parameters also we are trying.
If I connect some IOs to this controller mm-hmm. and I want to access the state of those IOs on a web,
not possible.
No.
क्योंकि
एच एम आई एक्सेसिबल नहीं है वेब पेस्ट
Some automation in the program, maybe it stops working.
Maybe
so
we can just
try it
out.
Only for monitoring
some of the parameters.
Only for
monitoring. Not
for operation.
Okay,
let us check. I'll just open a web visualization and we'll see how it works.
Mm-hmm.
Our controller default IP address comes with the 192.168.10.50. So if anything hanged, any program hanged out, the software got corrupted, we have a button over here. If you remove this cap, you can reset it and it can go to the factory default.
This is just for configuration.
Monitor.
So this is the web visualization page which we are getting it. You can do the network setting, the system setting, and you can know your machine, what machine you are connected.
This is different. This is just for configuration.
Yeah, that is what I'm telling. This
what?
Is only for the configuration.
Only for configuration. You can put one of the IP on DHCP also.
Yeah.
Just a
configuration.
HMI will not come in
wait. But it is there. I think I have seen some of the
controllers. Let us give the feedback. Actually,
yeah,
still they are going to launch the new version. They can put it on.
It's the beta version of our product. This is just the beta version of the product.
They may be adding.
Yeah, sure. It's
because right now they just launched the configuration part, and they may be adding those features.
Exactly, we'll give as a feedback for them. If they're making, they can incorporate it in this.
Yeah, definitely.
That will be fine.
Where
so
is the research being done?
This is our US division, Cleveland.
Do you do some work here also, or do you work here in India?
Here we will customize, like we can tell our requirement according to India also, and then we'll get a permission from there and we can do that R&D here. By just convincing them that it is very much essential to modify something from the product, so they will give us the permission and then we'll do that R&D on that.
So adapting you do here.
Yeah, sure.
Adapting
yeah.
To local condition.
Yeah.
Basic R&D is all done in the US.
Basic R&D has been done there.
Some
in the US also,
sir? Some of your people are they involved in R&D?
Yeah, that is what I was about to tell you. From the our every other location, Asia Pacific and from the Europe and from the US, representatives will be there and they will be sitting in a team and they will be developing it. So from India also, we have our R&D head who will go there. They will be sitting together for 2 and 3 months and they will be deciding the things. They will be putting their point and they will be deciding the product. So our representatives will be there. I'll just go. The visualization. This is the visualization. This is the anything machine line you can import. You can show it to the operators that this is your machine line. You can take a picture. You can simulate the things also, how the flow of the machine should be. So this is completely acting as a SCADA. It will. You can give all the simulations. You can see some of the speedometers also have made for the velocity visualization. We'll just go and demonstrate one by one.
This visualization, you don't have runtime.
This is the runtime. This is the runtime I'm running in. And it just run and show you.
No. But I cannot give this as a
separate. You can't give as a runtime. It comes with a full package with the software. Right now. Because we have given all the motion controls in this, and what our target was to give a complete solution once we are giving. So they have gave it made it specifically for the OEMs and the research purpose.
Yeah. Once the development is over, we are going to share these screens to the customer. I cannot ask him to just look at the fact what has happened.
Yeah.
But we are giving an option to peek inside what is there inside the code.
But that we can protect if you want. That is the feature available. You can give that is what I told you can protect whatever time you have invested to make that R&D. You can give a password. You can even give a password to a function block what you have created. So that features we are giving. Okay, just I'll enable the access. If you see these things, when it is active, this is acting just as an access. Two access I'm simulating it over here. The access is enabled, it will turn to blue, indicating that it has been enabled. I'm just giving the drive start. Basically, this drive start controls the brake, the electrical brake we are giving to the motors. Just for the elevator application, if the power failure happen, it has to drop the brake and it will clutch the free fall of the things. So I'm just opening the brake with this one, enabling the regulation, and now I'm enabling the access. You can see the access has been enabled here, and you will get a busy command that now the access is enabled and this drive is busy now to take the programs. I'll enable the next access and it's ready for you. We'll go to directly, we have a feature, we can go to, I hope you guys will be knowing about camming and gearing, right? So we can simulate the cams here, we can draw various cam profiles, we can run our axis according to that, one will be master and will be following all the slaves for that cam. I think in IIT Madras we have given one solution for that, they are studying the wave motion, wave generation, so they had to generate various wave patterns on the, they have a big pond where they will generate waves, they will study the height of the waves, the nature of the waves. So for that, they just have to give that amplitude and the frequency of the wave. They will feed it. Our actuator will be pushing the water back and forth, to and fro, and it will make a wave of that pattern. So if the motion is slower, the wave will be slower. If the motion is very fast, it will generate a more faster. So we'll draw a cam curve for that. They will just draw a curve for the wave and then put it on the controller, it will generate accordingly. I'm just giving the velocity for cam and gearing. I can have a various cam profiles, I can have 3 or 4 cam profiles, I can select which profile to execute that particular moment of time. So this cam table select is selecting the particular cam. Are we running out of time, sir? How much we have?
Yeah, 5 more minutes.
Okay, I'll just wrap it fast. I'm going to put that in cam in, and again we'll go to the control page. Access control. And we are going to say master should be starting. You can say my one motion has been started. I think the speed is pretty slow. So one of the motion has been started and the other is following a cam. It's in a cam right now. So you can see the difference in the motion. What is the exact position of that master axis and it will follow the slave axis. You will get a better understanding if I'll show you the curve what I have exactly drawn for that one. So this is the curve, this is the pattern what it is following. So for the master axis, when it is in 120 degree, your slave should be 200. your master is varying from 120 to 240 and your slave is just from I think 180 to 220. So this is the gradual move what I am doing here. Again I will go to the visualization page. You can see the axis over here. Actually we can make it more, you know, user friendly by giving the degrees over here. That also we can do it in very short time. I just made one demo for you, so I didn't got that much time. And apart from this, I'll just stop this and I'll just show you two axis gantry system also. We'll just give a stop command for this one. For giving a stop command also, we have to specify what should be the deceleration rate for the stop. I'll just give 100. And jerk is nothing but the transition of acceleration from one profile to the another profile. I'll give it 1000 so that it will be smooth transition. It should not be jerky motion. And I have stopped the axis. You can see the axis has been stopped. Once I have stopped the axis and I want to run a new profile on that, it has to home, right? It has to go to the home location where it can start again. So this is again an example of a state diagram. You can't jump from one location to, say for example, camming, you can't go directly to gearing. It again has to come to home and from there it has to start the gearing also. So I'll just give a home command for this one. Both the axis, I'll just give a home command. You can see actually both the tags I think we have given the same. So both went to home position from here with a home command. And again now I can give a CNC. I'll just demonstrate a CNC page for you. Okay. This is an interpolation we have made for two axis and it will just draw a pattern. First I'll show the G code for this one. We can write any of amount of G code and I think you guys will be familiar with this. I'll just, either we can write a G code or graphically also we can design it. And one more feature I want to just show you in this. If you have a readily available G code, you can import the DXF file directly. So any complex you have application or any drawing, CAD drawing you have, you can import the DXF file. It will draw the pattern over here. If you want to edit also, you can edit and again you can put it in the runtime. So this is the curve what I have drawn right now, just a normal pattern, and I'll just simulate and show you whether it is following that curve or not. So where's our visualization page? Okay. Okay, I'll just execute it and you can see it will try to trace that motion. One is the x axis and another is the y axis, and it is trying to, if you put a pencil on that red tip, it will draw that curve exactly. And this is just the simulation mode. If you have an axis, you just put a real axis with the same name, no need to change any program, then it's readily available for you. You can change the speed. We have online editors also. You can edit online. We have a CAM editor online also. You can edit the CAM also online. So this is the CNC part I just wanted to demonstrate. And just to give a look what program I have made for this, some of the crucial function blocks. Let it complete one cycle. So what I mean to say is these things what you are seeing, these are the face plates. These are the standard now coming with the IEC language, CODESYS 61131, I think. So this, once your programmer has been changed or shifted to other department, no need to like sit with him and understand the things. This is a readily available template with us. So if he is using this for a CNC interpolator, anyway he has to use. If he goes also somewhere, the next programmer, he knows the things. It's a readily visualized, so nothing will be changed. So it's very programmer friendly also. I'll just show you the programs what we have made it. I have made this program in the CFC language, that is a continuous flow chart. We can specify each block is there in the library. You can make your own function block and put it on the library also. That feature is also available, and then you can put a password on that also if you don't want to share it. So these, I'll just show you some of the libraries also. This is the MC power block. for giving an absolute move, we have taken, we can take an absolute move here, we can give the position, execute the things, relative. If you want to move from one position to another, relatively, you can move it from there.
So this can work for 5-axis CNC also?
This can work for 9-dimensional, we can specify.
Which motion block you will use?
Yeah, that also. Yeah, that also. These are the PLC motion programs, not the CNC. The bottom is the CNC here.
So now you have block to redirect CNN code also, right?
Yeah. So this is the CNC program which I have made in this. Just show it. What I was saying is readily available blocks are there for transformations forward.
Okay,
so you have a readily available blocks here. And, for reverse, forward and the reverse you have. Whether you want to control your axis by position, we have by position and velocity also, or only velocity also. So all three availables are there. And if you see, it's there for 2 gantry. These blocks are available for 5 gantry also. You just have to, maybe I am online, I can't show you. I'll go offline and now show it. Okay, so we'll just see. So readily SM3 CNC library is available. You can explore this one. You have lots of things in this. Files, managers. Your direct access controls are there, G-code viewer is there. It's a very nice thing. I have not explored fully. So we are exploring together right now. So I think this will support a small basic application readily available. If you have more complex, you can make it with this. You can customize your own function. You can put it in the library and you can circulate in your firm. And you can use it. So I think that will be all from my side for the demonstration.
Thanks, Arun.
Always available for the support.
Yeah.
And for sure, give us some feedback.
You have to extract support from them.
Yes, surely.
Now my question, I should come on that. Because DVD I will give only to those who will explain me the difference between camming and gearing. So when I say motion, we will be implementing, in which situation you will prefer to use camming, and in which situation you will prefer to use gearing?
Camming.
Any answer?
Where the speed ratio is needed?
Gear ratio
so
is needed. Below.
Yeah, I'm just asking about the example. Everybody knows gear can be used for speed reduction or speed decision. Can you just cite one example where I can
use? Sir, for valve opening we can use cam.
That cam is different than this gear, this camming. The very functionality behind us remains same. When I say motion camming using this kind of PLC control, so what you understand out of it?
In gearing.
Suppose if I have to do a circle bracing, what I will use, camming or gearing?
Camming.
And then gearing?
Linear.
Can you give example of gearing?
In the windmills.
No, windmills are not coming. So exactly what we will do with the gearing?
Conveyors.
Can you give one geometry that I can trace by using gearing between 2 axes?
Spindle motor movement for cutting CNC operations, spindle motor very change in RPM.
If I just say I have a 2-axis motion, XY, and I will be using this program to generate a motion, and then I would like to generate a particular geometry where I supposed to use gearing.
Straight line.
And then if you have a curve and other, as you have shown some of the graphics there, then you will be requiring that. Okay. Thank you.
statement of thanks for his progress over there. The good part is that he has demonstrated the hardware he got, I think, in hands last month only. So that's what he did, a lot of preparation and then come for demonstrating over there. Many thanks to him and his team. Here we had a mental health, we have not made it over here, so thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you very much.